Hello and welcome to this new video. In this video, we are in the beautiful country of Portugal. And this is our Airbus H135 standing in front of me with the beautiful rotor troop. This is an addition that came to the helicopter in, I think, update 1.4.1. And now we have this beautiful rotor troop, which is amazing on this helicopter. Today we are on a holiday with our 135 in a little farmhouse here. So a little farmhouse, pretty big farmhouse as you can see. So we are on a holiday here, as you guys can see. This is the whole land. So here we have sort of a farm that we have some mini houses, the big house and the garage and stuff, and the hangar for the helicopter. And this is where we land the helicopter over there. So that's pretty cool. We'll start. So of course, there are a lot of fields over there. And this is amazing. Imagine you live here and you can just land your helicopter in your backyard. That's incredible. So we're just going to start, and we're going to do a quick flight around where our vacation house is. So me and the co-pilot are on a vacation over here, just in this beautiful country of Portugal. So we are going for a quick flight. So let's get in. Bam, we're now in the helicopter. So we'll open our iPad and we'll start by closing our baggage door. So that one is now closed. Then we'll close the middle doors and we'll just keep the front doors open for air conditioning because it's really hot here because it's summer. So we can't turn the avionics on without the battery. That's not that logical. Standby battery, avionics on, after fuel, forward fuel, pilot heat not needed because it's really, really hot here. We'll just turn all the lights on, but not the landing lights. Now everything is starting up. As you guys can see, we are going to take a quick flight via the river and then we'll land at Faro Airport. I have gone to Faro Airport a lot of times in my life. In real life with the 737s because I fly from Belgium to there. So that's most of the time with a 737. But now we're going to fly with an Airbus H135. So we'll start up the engines. Engine 2, engine 1. Now we can hear the engine starting. As you guys can see, you can see the rotors move when I move the cyclic. So that's a really cool addition also. So whilst the engine is starting, we will close the front seats, make sure collective is down. So seats are closed. Now the engines are nearly started, so we'll turn off the standby battery. We'll take a quick look in the back of the aircraft. This is beautiful. Okay. Let's go. Look in front of us, nothing. Look outside. We'll really have to watch out for these trees. Or we have to put in a lot of pedal and turn to the other side, or we'll just need to go straight up, which is going to require a lot of power. But luckily we're not loaded that heavy. We only have two people and about 20 kilos of luggage, so that should be okay. I think I turned the engines on too early. Yeah, I thought they were already started, but no. So we'll still have to wait. I hope they will start soon. Wait, if I... Oh, no. Okay, I'm really bad at this. I will just prime engine 1, then that one We'll start now. Yes. Yep, now it's getting started. Yes, okay. It's not that healthy for the life of the engine, but I couldn't really get it started. That's just don't know what all these buttons do. Clock. Oh, that's pretty handy. I can see the time and stuff. So yeah, I'm just waiting for the engines to come on. So yes, step one is now idle. So we'll take prime off and set engine fuel prime on engine two, because I think I messed up something in the start. So that made it so I couldn't start him right or something. So we're going to set this on here. And this one is also ready now. So we'll take prime off this one. And now we can get ready. Start up the engines. Yep. Now they're starting. Look at that. Beautiful rotor animations. Beautiful. Okay. Now we kind of have to make a very difficult decision. How are we going to do this? So are we just going to try go straight up, which isn't going to be easy, or are we going to put in a lot of pedal and go to the other side? I think we better just do straight up because the pedal is going to be very hard, and with the trees it's not that safe. So just going to try to keep it in a hover, which is really hard if you're going far off the ground. Oh, make sure you keep it far away from the trees. Okay, but we are going up. Put in a little bit of pedal. Now we're nearly above the trees. And now we'll get some translational lift. We were really close to that tree. That wasn't really safe or realistic. A little bit more power. Put in some translational lift. And now we'll decrease the power. Enter. We'll go to about 400 feet. Because we want to see the river. Look at how beautiful this is, the river, all the farms and landscapes and stuff. It's beautiful. Okay. Follow the river, because if we follow the river, we will eventually also get to the airport. And we have clearance from the airport to go over there, so we can just land there. This is beautiful, and with the little fields of water and stuff, look like rice fields, but I don't think they are. Not sure, maybe they are. We'll be flying over them now. Okay, we are at the airport now. So we'll slow down. That was a really big flare. Now we'll try to get to 60 knots, stay at 60 knots. We're a little bit lower now, that's not that good. Okay. Now, I'm not sure they didn't give any advice on if there are any helipads over here, so we'll have to look, but I don't think there are. So we'll just have to land at a normal gate. We'll go to the last one over there. Make sure we don't go over the runway because there are some really big planes, as you can see, that fly here. There I see also a smaller plane, so we'll land next to that one. Also see a car driving. We have to make sure we don't fly into that car. Oh, he is turning. There is the other plane. Here we see the yellow stripe. So just land next to that one. Flying off. We don't really have to flare a lot more because we are already going very slow. Over the collective. Then we'll try to get all the stripes on the ends. I've been training a lot on flying the H135, so I hope I can do this. Lower the collective, and I think this is about right. A little bit of pedal, so we're standing straight, and then we're just going to lower the collective. Yep. Bam! Landing. So, collective is fully down. Oh, I can turn off my seatbelt rewards. That's strange. Okay, so we'll start by. We'll already put him in idle. Open all the doors. Ventilation, because it's really hot in Portugal. And we'll just have a look over here. So we've flown from here just to here. So I'll shut it down, and then this was the first part of the Portugal holiday series. In the next part, we will fly a new flight and go to a new place. So I'll now just turn off the aircraft. Make sure it's completely standing still. Okay, first one is off, second engine is also off. Would you look at that? Rotors are going already a lot slower. Bam. Now they're at a standstill. Okay, so now we have to turn off everything. So I'll just close these ones. We don't need those to get out. Just leave the front doors open so that way we can get out. Now we have to turn off our battery and then the av no, our fuel also. Nearly forgot the fuel. And out just our avionics. Thanks for watching. See you in part two.